SpinRite. Repair hard disk failures and recover your data. Maybe. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question. I have a file in my docs that I cannot delete. The error message that comes up says cannot read from source file or disk. The problem is that backup is not able to get beyond the folder where this file sits. What can I do? Cannot read from source file or disk is often an indication that your hard disk has a bad sector, and it's literally unable to read some or all of the file. Another error you might encounter is the dreaded CRC error, which means effectively the same thing, a problem with the data on your hard drive, or more specifically, a problem with the physical characteristics of your hard drive. Hard drives are fairly cheap these days, and replacement is often a practical solution. However, if the data you can't get to is important, or the time and hassle of replacing the hard disk is too daunting, SpinRite might be an answer. SpinRite's been around for, gosh, 2 decades now. I avoided using it for a long time because it hadn't been updated for a good period of that time. It recently received a major update, which is why I'm resurfacing this recommendation. It's now version 6.1, and it now works properly with current disk technologies, SATA interfaces, UEFI, etc. SpinRite works at the physical level of your hard disk. It's specifically designed to work on your hard disk's magnetic media in two ways. It rewrites the data on your hard disk to make sure that the magnetic signals used to encode the data are clear and crisp. This makes them easier and faster to read and maximizes the lifespan of the encoded data. It also recovers data on your hard drive where those magnetic signals have become weak or corrupted. SpinRite will go through exhaustive lengths to recover data when it encounters a sector that for some reason cannot be successfully read. Once it's done so, it'll either rewrite the recovered data to the sector or move that data to a different sector, a different physical location on the disk. In other words, two primary uses, maintenance and recovery. You can guess which one gets used more often. If you listen to the Security Now podcast, you'll hear SpinRite's creator, Steve Gibson, present a testimonial pretty much every week about how SpinRite saved someone's day and data. His stories of recovery run the range from a simple it won't boot scenario to the complex and even the extreme. Physical disk failures, like CRC errors, aren't always reported as such. If your hard disk is struggling and things seem slow, it could still be a bad sector that's causing your computer to try and try and try again until the data is successfully read. Occasionally, if your computer suddenly won't boot, or perhaps no operating system, or NT loader missing, or any of a number of initial errors on startup, it's because there's a bad sector that the bootloader doesn't report as such. It's important to realize what SpinRite is not. SpinRite works at the physical level of your hard disk, the magnetic media, and knows nothing about files and folders or even disk formats. That's one of the reasons it works not only on EXFAT or NTFS formatted drives, but also on drives formatted for use with Macs and Linux. It's not trying to understand the data on the hard drive at all. It's simply looking at and repairing each sector regardless of its contents. That means it won't repair data that was improperly written. It doesn't replace check disk or undelete utilities or file recovery utilities like recover or get data back. These tools all operate on the data stored on your hard drive, not the mechanics of how that data was stored. What SpinRite does that no other tool does is work to repair and recover from physical errors on the hard drive, like bad sectors, CRC errors, and the like. Now, a few caveats. SpinRite can work on external USB drives if your computer's BIOS supports it, many do not, and regardless, running SpinRite over USB makes it extra slow. If you're facing a problem with an external drive, it's often better to remove the drive from its enclosure and connect it to the computer directly via an internal SATA interface. SpinRite can be slow. Depending on the level of work you're asking it to do, it can take a few hours on a drive with no problems. If the drive has problems, the timing varies dramatically depending on how many and what kind of problems there are, and how successful SpinRite is at correcting them. It could add next to no time at all, but more often it adds minutes or hours to the process. Extreme testimonials I've heard recount SpinRite successfully repairing a disc after working on it for days, weeks, or in at least one case, a few months. Now, SpinRite cannot recover from extreme hardware failure. If the disc doesn't spin, the drive circuit board has been damaged, or the disc's read-write heads no longer read or write, that's beyond SpinRite's abilities. SpinRite can be controversial. Some say that its intense attempts to recover data could actually make matters worse, and that if you're at the point of using it, you should rely on a data recovery service instead. My take is that a true data recovery services are very expensive. If you know you're not going to go that route, then you have nothing to lose and much to gain by running SpinRite. SpinRite is designed for magnetic hard disks, not SSDs. However, turns out that there is some evidence on the SpinRite site that indicates it can improve SSD speed in certain circumstances. Support for SpinRite is excellent. Now, to be clear, SpinRite isn't free. I spent $89 for it when I purchased it many years ago. And that's still the same price. It hasn't changed in those two decades. It's significantly less than the expense of losing, recreating, or recovering data. In fact, many data recovery shops begin by running SpinRite and then charge you a premium for the service. It does have a 100% guarantee. If you buy it, if you don't like it, if it doesn't work, they'll refund your money. The bottom line for me is that SpinRite is an extremely valuable tool to have in your arsenal. It doesn't do everything, but it does one thing that no other tool does. I recommend it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4316. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.